MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's Game 3 of the National League Division Series between the LA Dodgers and the Milwaukee Brewers. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, lots to talk about here as we get ready for Game 3.
And you got to figure here in a five-game series, the odds are long for coming back when you're down 2-0. But hey, it's not impossible. It's been done before, but you can bet the other guys are hungry to end this thing right here and now to give themselves a couple of days off before the next series. This should be a good one.
Set for what should be a good one. Lineups and first pitch are next. Adrian Houser gets the ball in Game 3 of the series. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, you don't see a lot of guys that have five pitches, right? Sometimes it's hard to master even two or three, but if you can master five like he has, he'll be in pretty good shape.
Now to the plate, here is Mookie Betts. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. This will miss as well, so he's in danger of losing the leadoff man here tonight. It's 3-1 now. Temperature was in the 70s earlier today, but 59 at game time tonight. Now a ball hit high in the air, deep down the line and left, hooking just a little, and it bangs off the monster. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
Well, looks like they were determined to be aggressive early, and it almost results in a home run in the first at-bat of the game, but he'll settle for a double and hope the number two man can pick him up.
At the plate, Corey Seager. Two balls and a strike. A runner at second, nobody out. Hit hard on the ground to the right, and that is into right field, a base hit. And they'll put the brakes on at third. Runners at the corners with nobody out.
Hey, not a great start for the pitcher right here. Started off with a double, now add in a single, and one of your middle of the order bats is coming to the dish. Man, I don't think this was the start he was imagining warming up in the bullpen.
To the plate now, Justin Turner. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
He's got a couple of pitches to deal with right here, but he's starting to lose command of his pitches. It might be time to take a step back and try to refocus and making some good pitches.
Runners at the corners here, nobody out. Now a ball grounded to short. This could be two. Long for one. Back to first, so they get the double play, but the run does come in to score.
It certainly looked like they might have had a big inning cooking there with first and third and no outs, but the double play kind of kills it. They did get the run in, but the batter doesn't get credit for an RBI.
Into the box, Cody Bellinger. And there's ball two now. To 2-2 now.
Hey, like to see a little bit more discipline than that. You get a count in your favor and swinging a pitch that bad? Not good.
2-2. Two out, nobody on. Full count to Bellinger, three balls, two strikes.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. And he fouls this one off. So 3-2 one more time. Now a slider here, but this will miss off the plate away, and it's ball four.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
Runner at first with two gone in the inning, and that brings up Will Smith. Set. Here comes the 1-1.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he can go in right here.
Here now the 2-2. Fly ball right down the line and left. Yelich gets there for the catch, and that ends the inning. It's a run on two hits here for L.A. We'll move on to the bottom half of inning number one. It's the Dodgers 1, the Brewers coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Walker Buehler will do the pitching in game three of the series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Well, this guy's kind of unique. How about a five-pitch repertoire that he has that gives him a lot of options for both righties and lefties? And if he's on, he could be really tough to hit.
So now here is Colton Wong. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Here now the 2-2. Is laid off up for ball number three.
Well, the 1-2 pitch didn't go his way, and now a miss there on 2-2. You know he doesn't want this at bat to get away from, so I think we're going to see a challenge pitch on a full count.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Once again, a 3-2. Goes the other way, and this is in the air out to left. Coming in is Pollock. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first down of the inning.
The center fielder, Lorenzo Cain.
Digging in now for the Brewers, Lorenzo Cain. His career numbers in this matchup, he's 1-for-3. Bases are empty, one man out. It's 1-2. Fouled off. Here's another 1-2. Breaking ball, and he gets him to chase it in the dirt. Smith is after it, and he makes the throw to first. Kane is retired, two down now. And with two away now, we give you another glance at our up-to-the-minute playoff bracket. And here in this game three of the division series, the big question is, will we see a sweep? Next for Milwaukee, Christian Yelich. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. The 2-2. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2.
You can bet these hitters are taking note of what the guy on the hill is working with. A long at-bat like this in the first inning can reveal a lot.
Popped him up. Turner is in his tracks now as he tucks this one away to retire the side. Gone in order are the Brewers. It remains 1-0. So here is Max Muncy. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Good action on the sinker, one and two. Hard sinker misses, two and two. And now a pitch on the way. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first down.
Well, I'm glad we get another look at that beauty of a pitch right there. You can't spot a sinker in a better location because even if you do get the bat on the ball, there's not a whole lot you could do with that. Textbook sinker.
Stepping in now, A.J. Pollock. Down low, two balls and a strike. Swing, and he launches this one to deep left field. Yelich going back. Gone! Over the monster for a home run. A solo shot here to left, his second home run of the series, and the Dodgers move in front now 2-0.
I can tell you one thing, you might get away with throwing a ball in that location in the minor leagues, but when you get one up like that in the zone right over the plate against these guys, you're going to get exactly what he got, a really bad result.
At the plate now, Gavin Lux. This one is smashed down the right field line. That's going to stay fair, and it's going to be back-to-back home runs. A solo shot down the line in right, and the Dodgers have now taken a 3-0 lead.
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
So now to the plate, Walker Buehler. Swing and a flare down the line. Here comes Yelich. He can't get there as it falls in.
Now back.
At the plate, Mookie Betts drives it out to deep right center field. Garcia giving chase, and he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out. Runner at first with two gone. Striding to the plate will be Corey Seager. Buehler leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Again, another foul ball. Short, and the throw to Wong, and the inning is over. So two runs come across here, both coming via the solo home run. On now to the bottom of the second, it's the Dodgers 3 and the Brewers nothing. Striding forward now, the Brewers cleanup hitter Keston Hiura. He's set to lead off the home half of the second.
Hey, Maddie, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
The 1-1 home.
That's a ball. 2-1.
Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball. 2-2.
His heater's got some late ride through the zone. A lot of late swings right now. You're only going to get to that pitch if you get the front foot down early.
At the letters, but called high. It's a ball. And solid contact there as this ball is belted high in the air out to left. And it's gone into the monster seats. So a solo shot here to left center field, and the Brewers are on the board. It's now a 3-1 score.
Hey, listen, there's an old adage in baseball that solo home runs won't kill you. This is one of the in that lineup. So a home run, a solo home run right here, is not the end of the world.
To the plate now, Avisail Garcia. And the pitch misses low and away for ball
two.
Two
and one.
Just inside, off the inside part of the plate, it's 3-1.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
Now a ball lined hard toward right center. Around first, digging for two. And that one skips up over the wall for a ground rule double. Standing in now, Narvaez. And here's a pitch inside, and that got him.
Whoa, he looks a little frustrated out there, and I don't blame him. He gives up a couple of hits early inning, and then he plunks this guy. He's fighting himself a little bit, so they might want to head out to the mound and try to calm him down.
Stepping in now, Travis Shaw checks his swing, but this will be strike two call. None out, runners at first and second. Smoked on the ground up the middle, and that's through into center field, base hit. Now a long throw home, and they're not going to get him. He's in there at the plate. So now time will be called as we're going to get a visit from the pitching coach here as he'll help to settle his guy down. At the plate now, Orlando Arcia. And that's outside. He lost in ball four.
What's the saying? When you find yourself in a hole, the first thing you should do is stop digging. Well, the guy on the bump obviously hasn't heard that one.
Striding in is Adrian Hauser, the potential tying run for him at third base. Narvaez on third, Shaw at second, Arcia at first with no outs. And this one's up around the eyes, 2-1.
You put yourself in this situation, you got to get yourself out of it. You got the pitcher at the plate, 2-0 count. You got to take your chances and throw something middle of the plate.
Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now. And a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. Count remains full. 3-2. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Pollock has a read on it. He's got it one away. And with only one away, no need to test it as he'll hold tight at third base.
Up next for Milwaukee, the second baseman, Colton.
Now back to the top of the Milwaukee order, digging in Colton Wong, trying to bring in the tying run from third here. So 1-1. 1-2 now.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
Grounded back up the middle. And that'll get by into center field for a base hit. One run is scored. Tag, and they get him at the plate as one run scores, but not the second.
Now back.
Into the box, Lorenzo Cain hit to first. He's right there. Muncy will win the race to first easily, and that ends the inning. So three runs on four base hits, no errors, and two left. We'll go now to the top of the third, and we are all tied at three apiece. All set for the start of the inning, and digging in at the plate, Justin Turner. Two pitch. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand. So they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
So now to the plate, Cody Bellinger. Line drive snagged on a short hop. And he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out. Next for the Dodgers, Will Smith flew out last time up. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul.
Super important situation right here for the pitcher to go 1-2-3. Get back in the dugout, regroup. He struggled early, but if he can knock out this 1-2-3 inning, I think he can right the ship.
Line to the right side. And a little self-preservation down at first as he pulls that one in to end the inning. Dodgers down in order. Through two and a half. It's three apiece. And we're back for the bottom of the third. Let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Well, Matt, during the break, I caught up with Craig Counsell, the Brewers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. They've been able to push across three runs to this point, but they've also made the opposition work extremely hard. He's thrown a lot of pitches, and they think they're going to have a good opportunity to push across a lot more runs as he tires or as they get into that bullpen.
All right, thanks, Heidi. And here's Christian Yelich now. Flew out in his only at-bat so far. The 1-1.
I think getting the leadoff man in every inning is important as a pitcher. When you're coming off an inning that you really labored through, it makes all the difference mentally.
The 1-2. Hit into right center.
Well, there's another base hit. This is just kind of like that gift that just keeps on giving, Hero. Both teams piling up the hits, and we're just in the third inning.
Yeah, their ears were open on both sides during the pitchers' meeting today.
Good plan at the plate, a lot of execution.
production from the offensive side on both sides.
At the plate, Keston Hiura. Strike called. Now the throw down. In time as he just gets the tag down.
Check out here. That's about as standard as it gets, and it didn't do him a lot of help on that steal attempt either. Could have been a different story if he took another couple of feet off the bag.
The 1-2. Swung on and missed strike three. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
To the plate now, Avisail Garcia. And he pumps the fastball by him here. One and two now.
Hey, guys, that fastball just registered 97 miles an hour. On a night like tonight where it's super cold out, if you don't get to head to that baseball right there and you get jammed, it's almost like getting stung by a pack of wasps.
Looped out towards short. And this will be taken down no problem for the final out of the inning. None left for Milwaukee. We've played three, and our score, 3-3. Back now at Fenway Park, and here's Heidi Watney with a report.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. They've been able to push across three runs to this point, but they've also made the opposition work extremely hard. He's thrown a lot of pitches, and they think they're going to have a good opportunity to push across a lot more runs as he tires or as they get into that bullpen.
Thank you, Heidi. At the plate now is Max Muncy. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Two balls and a strike to count. Now a swing and a miss at the hard sinker, and they're back to even 2-2.
In my opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
Got him on the good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight. Stepping in now, A.J. Pollock. Grounded to third. Shaw gloves it. Throw gets him. Two down. Next to hit is Gavin Lux. Off to a fine start in this one after launching a homer his first time up. Here comes the 1-2. Hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center field. But it bangs off the out-of-town scoreboard. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone.
Well, when you're hitting the ball as well as he is, every time you swing the bat, you're thinking the ball's leaving the ballpark. He had a home run last time, and he almost had another one here. Nothing wrong with a double off the wall, though.
Into the box now, Walker Buehler.
Oh,
and he's a little too high with that one. Two balls and a strike.
Good time to be a nine-hole hitter right now. More than likely going to get a good pitch to hit. The top of the order is looming on deck. Good spot to be a good hitter right now.
And he lays off again, ball three. Mookie Betts would be next. Ball lifted into the air out towards center field. Haynes under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Two out double, left stranded. Back with more from Game 3 after this. And now here is Narvaez. Last time up, he was hit by a pitch. Two strikes.
I got to count one and two.
And it's fouled away. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Not fooled there as this ball's hammered out to deep right field. And it's gone. Solo shot here to straightaway right field as they take the lead 4-3.
There's still some game left to be played, but that one swing could end up being a deciding factor in this one. Through three innings, it's about time to get that pitch count down, or he won't be out here very long.
Both teams with six hits so far. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Pollock has a read on it. One out. Next to bat, that's Orlando Arcia. One run in and one gone so far in this inning. A ball and two strikes now. Now the Dodgers get a right-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. Ball two. Four runs, six hits, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. Hit down the line at first. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Breaking ball swung on in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Arcia is retired, two down now.
The bat. No pitcher.
Now to the plate, the pitcher, Adrian Hauser. He flew out in his last debut. A 1-1. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Bellinger's under it. No problem with this one, and the inning is over. But the Brewers get a run, and it comes here on the long ball. We're through four. It's now a 4-3 Milwaukee lead. So that'll bring in Mookie Betts. 1-for-2 with a double on the ledger so far. Two picks. And he popped him up. Pira into foul territory. And no one can get there. It's a foul ball.
There's the heavy sinker right there. What makes that pitch so difficult to hit is not only does it change eye levels, it actually changes plane. You go to hit it at one position, and it's 6 to 8 inches dropping off the table and chasing your hands.
Next at the plate will be Corey Seager. He's 1-for-2 in the ballgame. Betts aboard here at first with nobody out. 2-1.
Boy, not exactly what you'd like as a pitcher. One of the keys is to minimize your pitches, attack the strike zone early, a lot of deep counts, and working himself into a lot of trouble.
In the air, down the line in left, and foul. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Wong for one. On to first, a double play.
It's hard to do anything with a pitch like that that's below the zone. And if you do anything with it, most of the time, this will be the result, a double play on a good pitch down in the zone.
Next up for Los Angeles, Justin Turner. No one on base for him after the double play.
Yeah, Matt, that two ball really changed the complexion of this inning. It looked like the middle of the order was going to have a chance to get a big hit with some ducks on the pond, but now they just have to try and get a two-out rally started.
Hit in the air to right field. On the move is Garcia. He can't get there, so the inning will continue. And now he'll get into scoring position with two away.
That was a great job of driving that ball, extending his arms very well, was able to get it over the right fielder's head, one hopping it off the wall for an easy double. That's one of those solid hits that you don't even feel coming off the bat.
Plate now, Cody Bellinger. Ball two with a sinker that runs off the inside. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at bat will continue. And another foul ball. Here's the 2-2. Hit on the ground out to short. Over the first, and that retires the side. One left for LA. They still trail it here, 4-3. Here's the second baseman, Colton Wong. Singled home a run in his last time up. The 2-1. Lifted out towards straightaway center field. Bellinger's under it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
The center field.
So one gone in the Milwaukee fifth, and that'll bring up Lorenzo Cain. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Giving chase is Bellinger. He makes the running play. Two down. Base is empty, two away. And up next, the sweet swing and left-handed hitting outfielder Christian Yelich. And a knuckle curve missed that time. 2-1. Three and one count of the Brewers left fielder.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
Reined in, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Three up, three down for Milwaukee, but they hold on to a 4-3 lead. takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Number 25, Brett Anderson.
Top half of the sixth about to get started, and next to hit is the catcher, Will Smith. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Now,
a couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. The 2-1 home.
Great situation right here, leading off the inning. You've got to find a way to get on base any way possible. But I don't like to take the aggression away from hitters. If it's in your zone, I want you swinging.
Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth.
Well, there's only a one-run cushion to play with, so he's got to be upset after he walked the leadoff man here. Go-ahead run comes to the plate, and there are no outs. This could be a very interesting inning.
So a runner at first now with nobody out, and that'll bring up the left-handed hitter Max Muncy. Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. There's one. On to first, and they get them both.
Well, they got the tying run on base, but one ground ball later, and it's gone. He's going to be frustrated with himself after that.
So now to the plate,
A.J. Pollock.
Drilled to first. A reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone. Wow, this is a perfect example of a wily veteran doing what needs to be done to deliver for his team.
Yeah, just watch this swing. Instead of trying to do too much with it and pull it, he stays inside the ball and is able to smack it to the opposite field for a double.
At the plate, Gavin Lux. Fouled away.
Yeah, Matt, you see the same pitch three times in a row and you find yourself down 1-2 in the count. Your head starts to get on a swivel here. Is he coming back with it four times?
That will have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. A big time strikeout and some raw emotion as he gets out of the jam. We'll have more of game three after this message. Corey Knable enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Now pitching for Los Angeles, number 46.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Keston Hiura. Here it comes. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1.
Bobby Cox always used to say, I'm going to put you in positions to be successful. Well, against the modern-day bullpen, easier said than done. These guys are throwing flames from all arm angles.
Here now the 2-2. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Man, I love watching a pitcher that just rears back and blows smoke by a guy at the letters. That's the ultimate challenge pitch. And for me personally, watching hitters swing and miss, man, that's a sight of beauty.
To the plate now, Avisail Garcia. Fastball, and ooh, that ran in and drilled him. Now to bat, Narvaez. It was a solo shot for him in his last at bat. 4-3 our score here as we play inning number six. Ball three.
He drilled the previous batter, and now he falls behind 3-1 to this guy. The last thing you can do, though, is throw a fastball middle of the plate right here.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. On the ground to second base. This could be two. Throw to Muncy to finish the double play. That retires the side. So nothing happening this time around. On to the seventh now in game three. It's the Brewers 4 and the Dodgers 3. Chris Taylor will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Number three, Chris Taylor.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Hit sharply on the ground. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven. Now back to the top of the Dodgers order, digging in, Mookie Betts. He doubled earlier in the game, 1-for-2 to this point. 1-1. Waves and misses for strike number two. We're in the seventh inning now of a 4-3 ball game. Hit back up the middle. On the first, and it's a fine start to the inning for Anderson. Two away now. First, Corey Seager is working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Garcia has a read on it. Handles it easily, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. Score holds at 4-3. Victor Gonzalez will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh.
Number 81, Victor Gonzalez.
Last half of the seventh here, and standing in is the veteran third baseman, Travis Shaw. And he fouls this one off. Again, a 1-2. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now. Swing, and he popped him up straight up, as this is right around home plate, and he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one. One away for the Brewers in their half of the seventh, and up next will be the shortstop, Orlando Arcia. One out, nobody on. Looks like he swung it underwater that time for strike two. This is skied into short left center. Seager calls for it. Two down. Luis Urias will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number two, Luis Urias.
Up high. 2-1 now. Bases are empty here with two men out. Hit on the ground is short. Scooped up. Throw on to Muncy. Gets him. And with that, they'll end the inning. Gone in order are the Brewers. But they hang on to a one-run lead, 4-3. Devin Williams has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 38, Devin Williams.
New inning set to get underway, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Justin Turner. The 1-1 pitch. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. After it is Yelich. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first down. Next will be the Dodgers cleanup hitter, Cody Bellinger, grounded out in his last at bat. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes.
Two balls, two
strikes. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. And that will never threaten the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan, D-Ro, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage.
Yeah, you know, D-Ro, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. 4-3 our score here as we play the eighth. Softly hit to the left side. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. Throw into second, not in time, and he's in there with a double.
Man, that swing looked like self-defense than a real quality swing. But, hey, he muscled it out there, and it was enough to get him safely to second. Those are the kind of hits that will drive you nuts as a pitcher.
Stepping in now, Will Smith. He took something off of it there. It's 1-2.
Last two pitches of varying speeds. Gave him a hard fastball, and then he locked him up with a changeup.
Here comes the 1-2. Doesn't catch the outside corner. It's a ball. The 2-2. Coming up. And did he hold up in time? A look down, and no, he went around. It's strike three. And that will bring up the versatile Max Muncy. Been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far. Guys are looking for him to change that right here.
Yeah, nothing better than coming through for the boys in a tight game, Matt, especially when you're kind of due to do something productive.
Hold the lead. Here's the delivery.
Nope,
and they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. Oh, not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow. He's got it to 3-1.
Well, you can see here, this has been a steady diet of off-speed pitches, and what has it gotten him? Not a whole lot as he's fallen behind in the count. 3 balls and 1 strike.
Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. 3 runs, 9 hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. Fouled off. Payoff pitch on its way. Got him! And he goes down on strikes for the third time. Clearly fired up to work out of that jam. Back with more from Game 3 after this.
Yo.
Scott Alexander is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 75, Scott Alexander.
Bottom of inning number eight set to go, and that'll bring up Colton Wong. And he looks at one in there, one and two.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
Here comes the 1-2. This is skied into short left center. Seager is calling for it. He's got it one away.
Boy, he showed some pretty good range heading pretty deep into the outfield to bring that one down. Thought the outfielder might call him off, but he clearly had it under control.
In now, Lorenzo Cain. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. Bases are empty, one man out. And it's fouled away. Here he comes again, 1-2. Hard sinker misses, 2-2.
I don't blame the pitcher one bit for trying to get the chase right there. He's been fouling everything off. He's still got the entire arsenal open to him, so we'll see what pitch he comes with next.
Lifted in the air out towards left center. On the move is Pollock. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
Now back, left fielder.
In is Christian Yelich. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Two out, nobody on. Swing and a liner. That gets down, and the inning will continue. He'll get it into second, and he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
As we take a look at the replay here, you can see that it was a hanging changeup. Nice job of staying back on it, and he's able to tattoo it for a double. And you know, if that pitch would have supplied more velocity, it might have been out of here. He hit it right on the screws.
Standing in now, Keston Hiura. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Two out here and a runner at second. Sinker, 3-2 now. Abisail Garcia would be next. Here's the payoff pitch. Fouled away. The payoff pitch. Making him work out there. The ninth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Bounce towards the second baseman. Throw in time and the side is retired. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one man left aboard. On ninth now in game three, it's the Brewers 4 and the Dodgers 3. Josh Hader takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to the door.
Number 71, Josh.
A.J. Pollock will stand in here hoping to duplicate what he did back in the second inning. We flash you back and take another look at a solo home run that helped get this offense rolling. Stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one. Up next, Gavin Lux struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
Good deception on the slider there as he's way out in front.
Yeah, that pitch is the equalizer. Left on left slider, down the way. He can spot it up when he needs to. That pitch is almost unhittable.
And the slider gets him swinging, two gone.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location. So a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Edwin Rios will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Number 43, Edwin Rios.
One run game here in the top of the ninth. Good pitch as this is swung on and missed, and now they're down to perhaps their final strike of the evening. And a full house here at Fenway, 36,984 on their feet. Right side and right into the shift. And he'll step on first for the out, and the ball game is over.
Hey, this was a pretty tightly played game. Got a little bit of everything in this one. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching, and defense in certain spots. This one was a fun one to watch.
A tight ball game all throughout. Winds up a slim one-run victory in the end as we get you one final look at our line score. And it's a 4-3 finish in this evening's ball game. The Milwaukee Brewers have won their first in three tries in this division series. Adrian Hauser is credited with the win. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
The final line score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious Brewers, 4 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 4 men on base. For the Dodgers, 3 runs.